Hello, welcome.
Take four celebrities.
Happy Christmas.
What were you looking for this year from Santa?
Well, world peace, really, and a diamond ring.
Each serving up a Christmas feast.
I mean, I personally love a firm pear.
Certainly nicer than a mince pie.
Then watch Seasonal Silliness.
Ah, look at my eyes!
I'm going to separate your desks in a minute. She's very naughty.
She'd be a good teacher.
Yuletide yodeling. And the odd turkey.
Well, I hate your pudding!
Before secret scoring sees one of them win £1,000 for charity.
Oh, look at that!
Gonna be in big trouble, man.
Welcome to Christmas Come Dine With Me. And first to host is drum and bass DJ Goldie, who's positively brimming with festive cheer.
I think Christmas is very overrated.
Good start.
Most people think that Christmas is woolly jumper, by the fire, little pipe, slippers on. It's not going to be that kind of Christmas here.
I love Christmas. I actually smuggle in Christmas decorations all year round.
No stranger to telling the odd Goldie how to behave is our second contestant, no-nonsense Blue Peter presenter Janet Ellis. Yes, very good, dear.
I do like, to be in control, yes. I mean, it's like putting on a show. You've prepared it, the curtain rises, your meal's on the table, and if the audience shuffle around and their mobiles go off, I'm going to get cross. And I'm still going to use the naughty step.
Reckon you'll need that for tonight's host. Who, under the watchful eye of his wife, Mika, gets cracking with his mane.
Oh, look at this, babe. Look at this bad boy.
The bad boy in question is a leg of lamb to be roasted with a lemon and herb stuffing.
I really hope this mint sauce with the lamb. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. I will literally just put it all... I hope that's not insulting if I put it all over the meal.
Probably. Our third competitor is everyone's favourite stocking filler, Footballers' Wives actress Susie Amy.
I often call my mum and ask her to make me things and bring them round. Seriously.
Oh, surely you can't be that bad in the kitchen.
This is going to be awful.
Clearly you can. Boy. Meanwhile, Goldie's getting silly with some stuffing.
Ah, look at my eyes! I can't see my eyes!
Probably because you're wearing Grandma's sunglasses. He rubs his concoction into the lamb.
Garnish.
Get it all in the crevices.
In the crevices, baby. So when you're a homeboy, you need to roll, you know what I'm saying? You get on a roll. Yeah, I'm gonna roll.
Yeah, we're as embarrassed as you, Mrs. Goldie. Next, he rolls his joint and adds Christmas decorations.
Merry Christmas, everyone! Look at me fly in my reindeer lamb thing.
The reindeer lamb thing is doused in red wine and it's ready to be cooked just before serving. Main done. Next job is dessert. Vanilla creme brulee.
I'm not really a dessert.
No, you're not. You're legendary 70s crooner Tony Christie.
Dreaming dreams of Amarillo, that sweet Marie who waits for me.
Christmas music is always sleigh bells, chestnuts roasting by an open fire.
Not round Goldie's.
This is the thing we like the most in this kitchen, this house. We like one of our specialities is... It sounds like it's a Greek chef, but I am cooking creme brulee.
Oh, just get on with it, man. Finally, he mixes egg yolks and sugar.
Stop licking it.
Before combining with vanilla cream. The dessert will be baked before serving.
He plays drum and bass. He cooks creme brulee. He are ya?
We're beginning to wonder too. Finally, it's on to the starter. Blue cheese, pear and caramelised pecan salad.
Going to be quite a heavy one, I think, with the caramelised pecans and blue cheese together. But there's a little bit of pear in there too, so that's one of our five a day, isn't it?
Thanks, Mum.
Bring me my popcorn wok!
Woo!
Ba-bam!
And here it is, ready for Goldie to caramelise his nuts. Woo, indeed! They'll be added to the rest of the starter once his guests arrive, leaving plenty of time to embarrass the missus yet again, poor woman.
You never knew I was this homeboy in the kitchen, did you? Hmm? Huh? Never knew. I'm that kind of power in the kitchen. There is nothing I cannot do. There is nothing.
We'll see about that as your first festive guest is here. Susie, suited and booted, as per Goldie's old school dress code.
What up?
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm Susie, how are you?
Hello, Susie. Who's coming to help yourself? Help, help.
I thought there was nothing you couldn't do. How about a few compliments?
I feel really old-fashioned now, because I actually don't know who you are.
Like, I feel pretty bad.
Don't feel bad.
No, do feel bad. Next up, and looking less old-school and more school-mom, is Janet.
Welcome!
Whilst Goldie is looking frankly ridiculous.
Sorry about this, small little bad feet.
Well, hello, elves. Goldie, that means all we need is frankincense and myrrh.
Frankincense and myrrh,
and we got Christmas.
Did you get that out of a cracker?
So you like thought old-school was Mad Men?
It can be kind of vintage, yeah.
I love it, it's great, it's brilliant.
It's called putting your guests at ease.
Last to arrive is the ghost of Christmas past, Tony Christie.
Word up! Word up! Oh my god! Oh my gosh, it's Peter Gambaccini! The mafia's come! The game's up, boys! The game's up!
Hi.
Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm Tony Christie.
Hello, Tony Christie. How are you? You're very famous, Tony Christie.
Very dapper.
I remember you when I was a very young man.
Sounds like he's calling him old.
I mean, I don't know about old school, but when Goldie opened the door, I thought it was the Jimmy Savile school.
Now then.
Well, this is a bit of a mixed bag. It's like, we look like you're on holiday and we're the kids.
Who was it said the art of hosting was dead? Coming up, goodwill to all men.
Trying to get a smile out of somebody is a pretty difficult task.
Christmas cock-ups.
Ow! I can hear noises. It's just some of them are a bit alarming.
And a choir of angels.
Heavenly.
Ah!
It's Christmas, come dine with me. And DJ / actor Goldie is entertaining three other celebs in a competition to win £1,000 for charity.
It's Christmas time, it's reindeers. Hello, babies. You say hello. It's my little reindeer.
But not everyone's digging the dogs.
Tony's the one who's desperately allergic.
They went straight from me because they know that I'm allergic.
Antihistamine when I get back.
Full of sympathy for the delicate little flower that is Tony, Goldie does what every good host would do.
Come on then, sit down then. Smile, guys.
Takes photos.
Is your dog allowed on your sofa?
Bowie, come off there now. Get down. Come on now.
Come on. Out.
Tony.
Fortunately, our host has a classy solution.
We'll get you right as rain in a second, mate. How would you like your shoes shine there, sir?
Yeah, very nice.
All right, there you go.
Yeah.
Let's get him off there.
Very good.
There's a whole week of this still to go. And Goldie's not done yet.
Hey, guys.
Oh, what now?
Yes. Be very careful to come near his face because he's very jumpy today.
As if they're going to do that.
His name's Lanny.
Lanny.
And he bit me 2 days ago. There's the marks because he was hungry. He bit me 3 times.
Okay.
No, but what I'm saying to you is, you're welcome to come strong. It's great.
I don't know why anybody would want a boa constrictor as a pet.
Is this how your midlife crisis hit, do you think?
Yeah. Come on, mate.
I used to have canaries.
Why doesn't that surprise me? On with the food!
No pressure.
You're in your own time, fella. Finally, he coolly assembles his starter. Blue cheese, pear and caramelised pecan salad. This is going well, isn't it? Fortunately, Tony's on hand to bring a touch of festive cheer.
Apparently the lowest rate of stomach cancer in the world is in Mexico, where they eat chilies.
Wow.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas, everyone! Yeah, perhaps a change of subject would help?
Well, the pear was nice. Rather than it being cooked and being soggy and warm, I thought it actually worked.
I mean, I personally love a firm pear.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, I'm back!
Back in the kitchen, Goldie reflects on his newfound friends.
I actually don't care what my guests think of me.
Well, that's just as well, because I'm not sure they think much so far. Time for the main course, roast leg of lamb with a gravy that makes school dinners look gourmet.
Nice and crispy.
The lamb was slightly overdone, but delicious. It depends on people's taste.
For me, she should never taste garlic. It should be there but not seen, if you know what I mean.
Time for another stab at a thing called conversation. Now, remember, everyone, it's Christmas.
Trying to get a smile out of somebody is a pretty difficult task in this country.
Oh.
It really is. I catch the train to do Bikram yoga most mornings, and just looking at people, you just like looking at people that just look so miserable and ugly. They don't want to... They're going to work, I understand, but they look miserable. If you think
people
you'll be...
get scared on public transport, don't
well,
they?
Well, no, I think people look at me and they go, it's like the Jews are brought by the cup, but I don't care, I don't give a flying, whatever that means.
But isn't that mainly that they're doing what they do and going where they go and they're saving the best bits for other people?
People look pretty, pretty miserable.
Well, that's cheered everyone up.
So we better start on the dessert stuff. Not that that's a cue for the dessert, then, I think.
They'd probably prefer to skip it.
Goldie's doing quite a lot of the talking at the moment.
A dinner party is supposed to interact, and you're supposed to... If there's four people, you say something and they interact.
Do you know what? My dogs are eating well too. They're going to love that. They're smelling that right now. They're going, Dad, we got lamb.
Whoa, you're going to give that to your dogs? Whoa. It's going to be... Aren't they going to be a bit untidy after that?
They eat watermelon. Melon, curry, they everything, and they have a human diet, and they're great, and their poo's solid as a rock.
Oh, every line's just so festive.
Tonight maybe hasn't been quite Christmassy enough for me. Apart from some decorations, there hasn't been a lot of talk of it.
And I wonder whose fault that is.
It's been a long day. You've had a long day. Time for creme brulee.
His last chance to inject some Christmas spirit into the evening is dessert. Vanilla creme brulee.
Look at that.
Mm.
It's always good at pudding you have to crack.
Mm. I like creme brulee when it's too wet. Usually instead of four, I use six eggs, six yolks.
Yeah, yeah.
And then whisk it a little bit longer. That's why the fluff, they get a bit more fluffy.
Doesn't look quite right, Goldie.
I actually would quarrel with Mr. Goldie about whether it should be a bit wet or not. I prefer the wetter custard. It's on record now.
I think that went pretty well. I think it'll take some beating, that meal.
I don't think so.
I'm going to give Goldie a 7. That's not intended to be a low mark, but I'm quite a hard taskmistress.
Tonight, I am going to give Goldie a 7.
I'm going to give it a 7 because Goldie is such a nice man.
Very charitable. So, not exactly a Christmas cracker for Goldie, who scores a good but not unbeatable 21. It's day two of our seasonal shindigs, and Susie's turn to see if she can beat Goldie to Christmas number one.
I didn't feel like it was a Christmas party last night. I felt that we were just at Goldie's house having a dinner party, almost like a one-man show, really.
That's a good dinner party, good wholesome meal, good love. What more would you want?
Modesty?
There's an element of stagecraft with a dinner party of any sort. Do you know, you're the director, you're also got the starring role, and he took both of those on. He also produced, wrote, and did all the choreography, and I don't think he left the lighting to chance either.
So that's someone off Janet's Christmas card list. Meanwhile, Susie sets to work on her starter, Merry Mushroom Soup.
There's something uniquely English, I think, about the fact that we take any old thing and stick an adjective in front of it at this time of the year, and it becomes seasonal.
I thought you liked Christmas. For her soup, Susie sautés shallots, mushrooms and thyme.
They might end up with a bit of nail varnish in here at this rate.
Tasty. She adds stock and her secret ingredient, masala wine.
This is the merry part of the merry mushroom soup. It's Christmassy.
After simmering for 30 minutes, she blends, ready to be reheated later. Next, it's on to the main. Double roasted pork with applesauce and all the trimmings.
I'm hooked on crackling, see? I could throw the pork away, eat the crackling.
That might be more likely than you think, Tony.
I've only ever done two roasts in my life. Another was a roast chicken that I made here a few weeks ago. Two of my friends were here. One of them refused to eat it.
Blimey, the other one must be easily pleased. Susie puts her apples and pork into slow cook before finishing in the oven.
Hopefully, it will be crispy. My emergency plan, if the crackling isn't happening in the oven, would be to put it under the grill.
And cross your fingers. Last up on Susie's seasonal menu, angelic apple pie.
You're getting pork with apple sauce and then you're getting an apple pie. So I've already had apple. I've had my pork. So you're not really challenging the menu.
Well, tough. Susie gets ready to roll her pastry.
Sorry, you just need to.
By licking the work surface. Tastes nice?
It doesn't taste of anything. So now we need to do it again. Because I've now tasted it.
Why were you licking it in the first place? Eventually, she rolls out her pastry top.
Oh, it's only perfect.
Adds caster sugar and even a Christmas star. Bless. And she's done.
I'm going to go and get changed, try and get my hair a bit crazy.
Tony, meanwhile, is confused by Susie's camp Christmas theme.
So I don't know what Susie's going to do tonight. I'm looking forward to the little surprise. Could be a striptease.
Christmas must be fun round your gaff. Fully clothed, Susie's ready to spread some Christmas love. One problem, her first guest is Goldie. Enjoy the decorations, did you?
Hello! Yes! Brilliant! Come in! Welcome to my grotto.
You alright? This is your little grotto, yeah? You alright?
How are you doing?
Yep. Christmas time.
We've actually got Santa here.
Hi, Santa. How are you, mate?
Oh, cheer up, Scrooge. Next to arrive is Janet.
Yeah, look at you gorgeous girl.
And finally, classic crooner Christy.
Hello, Tony. Come in.
Hi.
Tony is here.
Oh, Tony.
Tony.
To kick off the evening, Susie and her helpers...
Oh, it's time for the bread rolls in. Thanks, Liz.
...warm up the starter.
Just sit opposite.
Well, I think I'll sit with my back to the mirror because I don't want to see myself masticating.
Now, there's an image. Swiftly moving on, the starter's served. Merry mushroom soup.
Lovely.
Oh, you got me there, love.
Oh.
Definitely. Oh, you can just leave it. I could just eat this all night because I'm just mushing down. I love it.
Would you like any more?
I would actually like some more.
Of course, I'll go and get you some.
Because I am the Oliver of this group here, guys. Please, can I have
get
some
you some
more?
More.
Yeah, we get it.
Of course, I will.
Christmas. I had to pace myself.
No worries.
That mushroom soup was banging. It was good, banging mushroom soup, man.
It had a little kick to it, which is great.
I think she'd put a little bit of sherry in, I think. Just enough to merry it up a bit.
And merry things up it has.
Yeah, well, cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers. Well, God bless you all.
I think the really nice thing about Christmas is that for everyone who celebrates it, everybody's doing roughly the same thing at exactly the same time, and I can't think of any other time in the year when that happens.
Maybe the lottery, people are.
Oh, Goldie, you card!
Well, Susie's really gone to town on the Christmas theme because of the way she's decorated the place.
Nothing gets past you, does it? Yeah. On with Susie's main course.
The oven isn't big enough to cater for the potatoes and the pork in separate dishes, so I'm going to have to do them in the same dish, which isn't how I've done it before. But it should be absolutely fine.
Very hot, Susie.
It's all right.
No, seriously, that's too hot.
They're very hot.
Told you.
I need to get that off. I think I'm about to cause a fire.
Has she gone off? Where's she gone?
It's been a bit of a while.
Ow! I can hear noises. It's just some of them are a bit alarming, actually.
Put the pork onto a serving dish and let it rest.
This isn't what we did. So all of it, all the crackling, we're going to serve it separately.
No, we're going to put it under there and serve it with it.
You mean for me to take all of the crackling off?
Yeah.
This is why I've got a helper here.
Susie removes her soggy crackling and attempts to rescue it before giving up.
This hasn't gone perfectly.
Bit of an understatement, but here it is, double roasted pork with the apple sauce but without the trimmings.
I was going to say, where's my crackling gone?
Well, kind of had a bit of a disaster with the crackling. I've got crackling in there, but it might be slightly chewier than your taste.
I don't mind trying it.
I didn't know if it was worse to serve it when it wasn't perfect.
You're talking to Jaws here.
Do you want me to grab you a little bit?
You're talking to Jaws here.
Did you put it under the grill?
At least I've explained.
Have I opened a can of worms here? I'm really sorry.
I'm just going to warn you. I wouldn't necessarily have served it.
Looks all right.
But give it a try, just in case you like it.
I like the way you've done the veg in these little layers of vegetables. That's very nice.
Whole vegetable.
I know you, mate.
Hope those teeth are insured.
Crackling didn't crackle.
It was horrible.
And that's why she didn't want to serve it. But there's more to come from Goldie.
that when I was in a children's home at the age of bloody 9 to for a long time, I probably just sat and watched, you know, you on Blue Peter, probably, sitting there in a pair of pyjamas with a snotty nose, and didn't realise it. Do you know? And I realised now, because I went back and did a little bit of thing, and I thought, yeah, that's actually, for me, that's actually the woman that used to be on Blue Peter that when I was growing up.
What are you,
1965.
How old are you now?
I'm 45 now.
45, OK, so you're 10 years younger than me, so, yeah.
Yeah.
So when I, you would have been a little bit outside the programme's actual age
reach. How old would I have been?
Well, if I joined when I was 28, so you would have been 18.
Oh, OK.
Yep, it's that time of night again when Goldie insults Janet.
Gosh, she was my mum.
Bad move, fella.
My adventure mum or what?
My sister or my...
Yeah, true.
Sorry. Well, I'm 12-year-old mentally, OK? No, this is about, OK, big sister then.
More you know like
it. All right, best more like it.
I'd be in big trouble, man.
But she is a mothering kind of character.
What happened to old-fashioned chivalry? If you're going to say somebody's like your mum, pick somebody who is your mum's sort of age, and even then, call them your sister.
Yes, mum. And speaking of inappropriate interludes, Susie's Christmas campery continues.
Guys, I'd like to introduce Diva Fifa.
Yay! Whoa. Yeah.
You're having fun.
Well, we were.
The night's about to get a little worse.
Yes, especially for Mr. Goldie.
Silent night.
Here we go.
Holy, holy night.
All is calm.
I think my entertainment went down really well. I thought they were absolutely delightful.
Things we do, man, seriously, you know.
Heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly
peace.
Wow.
Well, the best carols I've ever heard.
I hadn't got a clue who they were. I thought they were the kind of people who would serve me in Pizza Express or something like that.
A bit harsh. Perhaps Susie's camp Christmas dessert will prove more heavenly.
There's no custard, then?
Custard?
I haven't made custard.
Oh! No custard! Oh. Apple pie with no custard.
Okay, basically, I would have just used... Like, I have got custard in there, I can heat it up.
No, you had to
just...
That's it. Too late now, baby.
It's all right, love.
Sorry.
Calm down.
No, I'm not saying anything.
Going to separate your desks in a minute. It's very naughty.
I have got custard in there.
But I'm saying to you, so custard's from the tin, right? And we could make custard, but from the tin. So I have the tin.
Relax, you're not actually on the witness stand. You just a conversation after dinner.
Yeah. And Goldie, you did eat it.
I hate your pudding. I can't stand your apple pie. This apple pie is disgusting. Look at you eating your apple pies. I can't stand it. Why are you even sitting there with it on your plate?
Goldie.
I love it.
Well, now, I just think we all need to calm down and then set that to music, and then it'll be fine.
I think there's been enough music. Home time!
Good God, man. I mean, custard, you've got to have custard with apple pie.
Oh, give it a rest.
For some reason, the boys got extremely naughty at the end. They better not do that tomorrow, because I'm not having that sort of shouty behaviour and heckling her about her choice of cream and custard.
It was really, really Christmassy tonight. Really got into the Christmas spirit. I think everyone did.
Well, tonight I'm going to give Susie an 8, because it was really Christmassy.
I'm going to give Susie 8, because there was sparkle there. The meal might not have been perfect, but she's learning.
No crackling. No custard, no cinnamon.
But she's still done better than you. Susie sledges her way into the lead with 22 points. Next, an epiphany for Goldie.
Well, I just got...
I do remember you! You were the girl in that room!
A new friend for Susie.
Hello, come sit on my knee.
And a happy, clappy Christmas for Janet.
Comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
It's day 3 and the turn of former Blue Peter presenter Janet Ellis to try for the £1,000 Christmas charity prize. Nice bun, by the way.
I can't quantify how much I love Christmas. I've always loved it and it's always exciting and I've never, luckily, got jaded and this week is not going to kill it for me.
You got that, Goldie? Janet begins with a dessert of panettone bread and butter pudding.
Panettone is a type of bread, I assume, but I think I have had it.
I absolutely hate sultanas.
Bad luck, Pud's riddled with them. Janet makes a classic custard. Watch and learn, Susie, adding vanilla and orange zest.
Look at that, isn't that delicious? You could just drink that now.
Rather you than me. She slices the panettone, ready to be covered with the custard later.
Sweet, isn't it? Look at that.
Dessert done. Next job is the starter, a winter salad of fennel, parmesan and spicy salad leaves.
It's a cleansing salad. It will clean the palate and into your main course. That's a perfect choice.
That sounds nice. I won't know if I like that until I try it, I would say.
And neither will Janet.
I haven't made this before.
What are you thinking?
You know, I've had all the individual things before. I just haven't actually had them, like, all together before.
She makes a mustard and parmesan dressing.
Ain't this fun?
It's really nice.
To be added to the salad just before serving. On with the main course. Yuletide fillet of beef.
With any meat, it's the timing.
If you say to me Janet hasn't done a roast, a few of them, they're into the thousands, isn't they? She's done that a few times, you can tell. That's going to be brilliant. Fantastic.
She's not that old, Goldie, but she does know how to sear a good fillet in a hot pan, ready for roasting later.
Hello, darling. No, she wants me, not the beef. Truly, that's all she's after. That is all she's after.
No, she wants the beef.
If Janet gets this right tonight, it's going to be a great meal. Fantastic.
The dress code is Kitsch 50s Christmas. OK, I'm going to have a think about that one.
Well, Janet's already given it some thought. Hello, Minnie Mouse!
I hope they really relax and enjoy themselves. Of course, if there is any trouble, I get a bit cross with them because it's no fun. It's against the spirit of the thing, but I think they're learning.
First to arrive is Tony, dressed as a 1950s crooner. Not much of a stretch for him, really.
Hello.
Yeah. Oh, Janet Ellis with a tattoo. Who'd have thought?
Gorgeous.
Sorry, is it?
No.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Hello.
Next, it's Susie.
How are you?
You look gorgeous.
Looking a bit like Herman Munster.
You look wonderful.
Sorry. So do you. Look at this.
I know, isn't it lovely?
Oh, I love this. You've got a lovely house. Oh, gorgeous.
And finally, it's, crikey.
Assume the brace position. Goldie's here.
Hey, good evening. Hey, how are you doing?
I hoped you'd dress up.
It's, Geraldo Gerald, Draper. I'm here to talk to you about air conditioning. Kind of hot in here. Maybe we can cut you a nice deal for the summer. From Philadelphia, I'm a car salesman. How are you? You good?
Goldie, you've truly bothered.
Sorry, Goldie could not make it tonight. So, Geraldo Draper's here. Listen, I got us some fantastic Cadillacs. I got us some nice, beautiful limousines. Nice Lincoln. Pleased to meet you, guy. How you doing? Heard a lot about you. Got all your records. Got all your records.
Goldie looks hysterical. Absolutely brilliant.
Can I get you a glass of Kia Royale?
I will love a glass of Kia Royale. I saw the movie. Fantastic. James Bond, right?
I do hope he's not going to keep this up all night.
I'm about to trash my career and let you have a laugh at some old Blue Peter albums.
Amazing.
Oh, no.
Well, I
do remember you. You were the girl in that room. I saw on the TV. It was you.
When you were 18.
You know, you go to that lost memory of when you used to watch Blue Peter and you think, that was her, the woman I used to see on TV.
Bang goes the street cred. God.
These are amazing. What a great thing to be able to keep.
I wish I had a mum like that. I wish I had a mum like that. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
Not sure she'd want a son like you, to be fair.
Do you have a Blue Peter badge?
Of course she does. You must have.
You must find one.
Well, most of them
A real dog. For me. Got Goldie. Think about it. This is like full circle.
But they can be really useful when traffic wardens are.
Ooh, can you send me one?
Lovely.
Come sit down.
Where does a car salesman sit?
Outside.
Well said, that man.
This is some bread I prepared earlier.
And here's something else she made earlier. Her winter salad of fennel, parmesan and spicy salad leaves, topped with some croutons.
Do start, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Very strong.
Too strong?
No.
I really enjoyed the starter. I could really smell the parmesan. It was a nice mix, slightly unusual mix, maybe.
The fennel salad was as light as you can get. It was absolutely delightful.
You guys know your wines. I just don't even know one.
I don't either, Goldie. And, Goldie, I think the reason that you and I don't know so much about wine is because we don't really
drink a lot of wine.
Oh, really? There was you playing Chardonnay.
I know, well, thank you. Thank goodness I wasn't drinking at that time.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't know.
And is it true that a lot of people named their children Chardonnay?
Mm. They did.
After
they
you?
They did. I believe there were a lot of babies that next year.
Who needs an Oscar, eh?
OK, let me have your plates.
That was delicious, though. Thank you.
Janet's making it look effortless.
They seem calmer tonight. They seem... Everybody is a little bit... And I think, without wanting to sound silly, they're a bit respectful.
Yep, even dressed like that, she commands respect. On to the main.
All I ask now is that it's nice. Ooh. Oh, look at it, so beautiful. Oh.
Janet's traditional Christmas continues with her Yuletide fillet of beef.
I'm looking forward to this. I've been looking forward to this really for a long good. Time. The booth's spot on.
Is it all right?
Spot on.
Absolutely lovely.
The bar's gone up again.
Sure you're not.
The beef was beautiful. I mean, absolutely amazing.
I think everyone went crazy for the beef. It was absolutely fantastic. It was cooked to perfection.
Does Sophie please not have some more beef?
You can, but I'm just going to finish mine.
Okay.
It's what I say to the kids, so, you know.
She's all about the value of, you know, wait till you finished and, you know, table manners. I never had table manners.
It shows.
Starving over here.
Really?
I'm joking.
You've got to wait till everyone's finished.
Oh, no, I'm waiting.
She'd be a good teacher.
And Goldie would be a terrible pupil.
You know, we were talking about your Chardonnay, you know, your name. Is your real name the one you're able to use professionally?
My surname?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. That's it's my family name.
Who did you start off as? Did you start off as Tony Christie?
No. My real name is Fitzgerald.
Is it? Mm. That's a sharp name.
It is now, but when I was starting out as a singer, it wasn't cool to have a name like Fitzgerald.
And why did you pick the surname Christie?
There's a film on called Darling, starring Julie Christie. And at the time, I was about 18 and 19, and just looked at this Julie Christie and went, wow, I'm in love. And I thought, what a cool name.
Goldie, what's your full name?
Clifford Joseph Price.
Can't think why you changed that.
Yeah, solicitors for oaths.
Yes.
Who started calling you Goldie?
I had dreadlocks, so people call me Goldilocks.
What? You used to have hair?
See, I always thought Goldie was called Goldie because of all the gold he wears.
Yeah, when did you get the teeth to match then?
Yeah, years ago, just years, 25 years ago.
Yeah.
Just doing jewellery. My friend was a dental surgeon in Florida, and I just learned the trade as I make teeth and jewellery and design. I'm allowed to do centrifugal casting.
I've come to love Goldie's energy. I love learning more about him. He's so artistic.
So, Goldie's back in everyone's good books, but Janet might not be.
Now, in keeping with the 50s theme, I thought tonight we'd make our own entertainment.
Yep, it's compulsory carols, topped off with Christmas jumpers. Yes, yeah, suits you, Clifford. Sing up, everyone.
I loved singing the Christmas carols. I thought that was really Christmassy.
Janet's certainly captured the Christmas atmosphere.
Oh, yes, you should bottle it and sell it.
That's the only time you're going to get me to sing a Christmas carol, I can tell you that.
With a pair of jeans. I think I can make that work.
Good luck with that.
Excellent. Happy Christmas,
I've turned into a barricade.
Janet's last chance for that £1,000 charity prize is her dessert, panettone bread and butter pudding.
You must never do a tango with an Eskimo.
I know where I'm spending my Christmas now.
Me too.
I know where I'm spending my Christmas now.
I'm not cooking. You know what I say, Janet's. I need to go to Janet's. I need to go to my big sister's house for dinner.
Can I have a hug now, please? It's just spring Christmas.
Ah, bedtime.
Very nice. Tonight was as Christmassy as you can get.
I absolutely hate sultanas, especially when they're big and juicy. And it was absolutely delicious. I just picked around them.
I'm giving Janet a 9.
Fantastic. Janet gets a straight 8.
Tonight, I'm going to give Janet a 9.
So, a Blue Peter badge for Janet, who's top of the class so far with 26.
Janet's raised the bar a couple of notches tonight. So, it's put a lot of pressure on me tomorrow.
Ho, ho, ho! It's the fourth and final day, and Tony Crooner Christie's turn. He lives in the Midlands, so he's borrowed a London house for his Christmas party.
The knife is sharp.
And to help him in the kitchen, he's dragged, I mean, invited his wife Sue along.
Right, this is the starter.
I'll stop you there, Tony. It's not the starter, it's your dessert. Passion fruit parfait.
I don't know how you do parfait. I know my wife talks about it often. I always hear this parfait going around.
Certainly nicer than a mince pie.
I don't know what a parfait is. What is a parfait? Is it? It's not quite a pavlova, is it?
Well, Janet, watch and learn from Uncle Tone, who starts by sieving the pulp from his passion fruit.
So I normally have my sous chef to do this for me. Isn't that right, Sue?
Boom, boom!
He's a lot quicker than me. I can't do it that quick.
For the parfait, he heats cream and sugar before adding lime juice. Ouch. And not forgetting the all-important passion fruit. I said not forgetting.
Shall we put passion fruit in?
Yes, now's probably a good time.
Ah, wait a minute. Do you do it now?
Yes.
Oh, right. Complicated. Why do we do this?
Because you want to win £1,000 for charity? If he can keep it together, Tony's starter will be portobello mushrooms stuffed with sun-dried tomato and basil gratin.
I'm quite surprised about that. I thought he'd be more of a kind of Parma ham and melon kind of a guy.
I'm rather partial to portobello mushrooms.
So am I!
Oi, Santa, shut it! Tony and wife combine basil and parsley with a mixture of olive oil and garlic, then add sun-dried tomatoes. The paste is spooned onto the mushrooms and topped with goat's cheese. Starter sorted, next job is the main. Duck in mulled wine with sprouts.
That doesn't sit well with me.
Ooh.
That sounds very Christmassy. I love sprouts. Duck's good. I hope it's nicely cooked.
Tony makes a sauce with red wine, vinegar and a bit of spice.
When you put a clove in wine, it always conjures up Christmas to me.
On to the meat, and he scores duck breasts and seasons, ready for cooking later. Next, it's those sprouts.
Sprouts are risky. Not everyone likes sprouts.
Can you do this one? Thanks, Natalie.
Yes, I think she can probably manage without you. Oh, he's back.
OK, right, here we go.
And looking even more confused.
Knife's sharp.
Put the knife down, Tony. First at the door for tonight's Crooner Christmas is Janet.
Uh-huh. Oh, my God, look at you!
Look at you!
You're absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, it's lovely to see you.
Why don't you sit on my knee?
Sit on his knee.
Oh, pop yourself down here.
I'll just sit on the side of the...
And you tell Santa what you want for Christmas.
Well, world peace, really, and a diamond ring, but not necessarily in that order.
Next, it's Secret Agent Goldie.
Oh, my God.
Tony.
Man in black.
Man in black,
baby. You look fantastic, baby.
How are you, man? You good? You good?
Come and sit down. Oh!
Hello, young
man. I'm going to meet my friend Santa.
Oh, oh, fine. No, that's not
me. Sit on Santa's knee.
Oh, I'm not going to sit on Santa's knee.
Sit down on Santa's knee.
No, it's not going to happen. Not going to happen.
It's going to happen.
I'll stay here. That's fine.
Thought, nah, mate, that's not Santa. Having a laugh. I knew him when I was young. That's not him.
No, it really isn't.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
And completing the party, Susie.
Oh,
go on,
Santa. Oh, young lady. Hello. Sit on my knee.
I met a different Santa earlier and he doesn't look the same.
I thought Santa being here started the night off really, really nicely. It just kind of made it Christmassy.
Well, happy Christmas, everyone.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Still to come, Susie reveals all.
And it just pinged over. You've seen it.
I felt ignorant suddenly and at a loss.
Goldie finally discovers some Christmas spirit.
Guess you're there.
And we find out who'll take the prize.
Look at that.
It's our final Christmas soiree, and singing legend Tony Christie is last to try for the £1,000 charity prize.
Happy Christmas.
Well, I'll sit in here because I want to be near the kitchen. If Susie, would you go there?
Of course.
With everyone here, Tony, or rather his wife Sue, finishes the starter. Portobello mushrooms stuffed with sun-dried tomato and basil gratin.
Ooh. Oh.
My little helper.
How lovely. Thank you very much.
That's pretty.
Gorgeous.
Thank you very much.
You've got to tell me how you've done this one.
As if he'd know.
Well done, both of you.
I'm not a big fan of tomatoes. I had to take some of the tomato off.
If sun-dried tomatoes were confiscated tomorrow, not a problem for me.
Do you guys always have Christmas at home? Do you ever go out to restaurants at Christmas, or do you always just at home? Me too.
Always at home.
My mum once suggested going away over Christmas, and I was so disappointed.
I've had some bad ones.
Why?
I was on my own in between a mad divorce, and I had this really horrible divorce, and I was on my own at Christmas. I'm right on my own. And I looked up on the internet and I found a catering company, but they wouldn't deliver. You'd have to go and get it. So I remember sending this is really bad. I sent a PA out to drive to go to a caterer's near Heathrow.
That's not bad, it's awful.
Get it in the morning and bring it back. And just
on Christmas Day,
and there's me sitting down on a table, kid you not, on my own, having a turkey dinner.
I mean, that's obviously a very sad image. What's even sadder is that he sent someone else out to get his Christmas lunch.
And he didn't even invite them in.
How's it going, dear?
I started it off for you, darling.
Oh, good.
Right.
It's got to be well...
Do I turn it over quickly?
Don't ask him.
It's got to have a minute, that's all.
Expert now, are we?
I think Tony's in the kitchen, but I don't think he's doing anything.
No. I think you actually said to him, what does this do? And it was the oven. He would go, not sure.
Spot on. Somehow the main is ready. Duck in mulled wine with sprouts.
That's lovely.
It's very Christmassy, isn't it? Clovey and
it is, yeah.
Garlicky and well, everything.
The duck could have been, for my taste, slightly less well done.
It's not as pink when it came out.
I don't like duck, unless it's crispy.
If I was going to judge it against other ducks, it's not the greatest duck. It was slightly overcooked.
Back at the table, Goldie's finally discovered the spirit of Christmas.
I think that you guys are pretty straightforward and I would definitely put you on my Christmas list.
Oh, amazing.
You say that like in a way, like, really?
Goldie has really taken to heart things we've said, even if he hasn't given that away. And each time he does, he comes back less defensive and nicer.
Will I be on your Christmas list?
Absolutely. The first night was intimidating.
Mm. Was I a bit too much? I must have been a little too much.
No, you were way too much.
You're not now.
A little bit too much.
Well, it was like opening the door to somebody who was actually saying, go back, there's enough here. All right, OK. But actually, I'm contractually obliged to come into your house. And so I shall.
Contractually obliged! That's
that one.
Thanks,
Tony. Tony, how did you feel on the first night?
The first night? I thought I was walking into a madhouse.
All I think it was the first night was you actually are quite interested in other people, and on the first night, I didn't think you were interested in
us. Oh, I'm so interested.
That was all. Now I know that. I know that now.
OK.
I absolutely know that now. Come on.
Goldie definitely wears not only his heart on his sleeve, but a lot of other things. Most of his internal organs, actually.
Oh, that's put me right off my sprouts.
At Christmas, when you get, like, the outtakes, have you ever done any gig or something where you've, you know...
Have you seen something?
Why have I got a guilty conscience?
There was an unfortunate moment...
Go on.
..on Football and Wine.
Tell us.
You've seen this? Where I was meant to be doing a photo shoot. My character, very briefly, was a glamour model. And I was posing like this, and the camera was kind of from here up, and it was a bra that did up at the front, and it just pinged open. You've seen it.
I didn't want to say anything. I paused. When I opened the door, when you all came around the house, I went to myself, do I know her? Yeah, I remember her.
You dirty old man. Time for a different type of festive cheer, I think. Tony's crooner Christmas steps up a gear as he pulls out his trump card.
Hello.
Beautiful.
It looks like a Top Shop commercial.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
When Tony's singing, you might say he's in his comfort zone, but those words are inadequate. He's just, he's at home.
Where the treetops glisten and children listen to
I thought the choir were fantastic tonight. Really, really festive, amazing singers.
Yay!
Thank you. That was lovely.
Can I have a Christmas hug, please? Can I have a Christmas hug? Christmas hug!
You've only just met them. Get your head out of there.
It's a special sound when a choir sing a thing like White Christmas. It gets you there.
And if that wasn't sugary enough, it's time for Tony's Pud, passion fruit parfait.
How pretty.
Thank you.
That's lovely. I didn't know what a parfait was. I felt ignorant suddenly and at a loss.
Tut, tut, Janet.
I didn't like the dessert because it was a little bit overpriced. It was too rich.
It was cream. It was delicious. It was cream. Parfait is cream.
Glad we got that sorted.
Well, happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Happy Christmas.
God bless you all.
Oh, I missed.
Poor old Tim. Tiny Tim.
On to the scores. Tony needs 27 to beat Janet to the £1,000 charity prize.
You could serve me a sandwich, it would be 8.
Tony gets a 7 tonight.
I am going to knock a point off because Tony had a lot of help. I'm giving Tony a 7.
Hey!
There we go.
Oh, well done. Right. Look at that!
In fourth place is Goldie.
I knew it.
In second, the tie, Susie and Tony.
Woo!
Which means that the winner is, in first place, Janet! Yay! Yay!
Well done.
Very well deserved. I'm really pleased to come joint second. I really didn't know how the other results would go. I knew Janet was going to win.
I won! I know. I'd forgotten it was a competition and I came first.
Well, Janet's a worthy winner because the evening was so perfect.
Can I come in your house for Christmas?
I want you all to come to my house for Christmas, yeah.
My result was always going to be fourth. Fantastic night.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Thank you for tonight.
You deserve it.
Well, I suspect we're all a little bit disappointed that somebody had to win. And, of course, they're just ever so slightly more disappointed than me.
We'll catch up on Jamie's Christmas best bits on 4OD. Go to channel4.com. 9 o'clock tomorrow night on Channel 4, it's singer Jamelia's turn to step back in time and visit the house that made her. Tonight, Christmas with Chris Moyle's mission, get Pamela Anderson under the mistletoe. He's next.